Hi friends, in this video we are going to discuss about pattern allowances. This is a very important topic. From this topic we can expect 2-mark problems in GATE. Pattern allowances. Patterns cannot be made in same size as like the casting, because the most of the metals in liquid form will have lower density than the solid state. When the liquid metal is cooled to become the solid, some shrinkage will happen in the final product, and final product will be little smaller than the pattern. So some allowances is needed in pattern making. Other than these, some other allowances also there. We will discuss in this video. First type of pattern allowance is shrinkage or contraction allowance. All metals will shrink during the cooling process, but there are some metals like bismuth, gray cast iron, these will not shrink. Instead, it will get increase in volume. Okay. In diagram, we can see the pattern will be given some allowance and made in oversized, and the final casting we get is in smaller size. By this, we can understand for getting cube casting of 10 mm, we have to make little bigger sized pattern to avoid the shrinkage. This is nothing but shrinkage allowance in pattern. This graph clearly shows the solidification of casting. This graph was drawn as temperature versus time. First, point A in the graph is marked as molten metal's pouring temperature. Then, graph made a slope from point A to B. What actually happen is metal will be in liquid form but loses temperature from pouring temperature to solidification temperature. Here point B denotes the solidification temperature, in which exactly liquid form begins to transform to solid state. Now point B to C is horizontal line, that is nothing but temperature is constant, but transition from liquid form to solid form happens by releasing the latent heat. Shrinkage will happen in these two processes also, that is point A to B and point B to C. Here point A to B is considered as liquid shrinkage and point B to C is considered as solidification shrinkage. In these two processes, mostly the metal will be in liquid form. So it is easy for the riser, which will be fixed above the mold, to feed the molten metal to the mold during these two processes. So riser will compensate both liquid shrinkage and solidification shrinkage. But riser cannot compensate for the process from point C to D, because the metal will be in solid state. This is called as solid shrinkage. Here temperature decreases from solidification temperature to atmospheric temperature or room temperature. So C to D, that is solid shrinkage, alone can be compensated by oversized patterns. Oversized pattern is nothing but the allowance given for making the oversized patterns. Shrinkage allowance will vary based on the metals. For cast iron, 10 mm per meter. For brass, copper, aluminium, 13 mm per meter. For steel, 21 mm per meter. And finally, zinc and lead have 25 mm per meter. For some of these metals, we have to keep these values in mind. That will be useful for the exams. Now, there are some exceptional metals also. We can see in the right side. They are gray cast iron, spheroidal graphite iron. These two metals, after the cooling process, casting product will become oversized than the pattern. That is nothing but negative allowance. This will happen because of graphitization, which will lead to increase in volume. For casting these two metals, smaller sized pattern is needed. Here we have one formula for calculating shrinkage allowance. Del L is change in dimension, that is nothing but shrinkage allowance on the pattern. Okay, del L is equal to L into alpha into TF minus TR. Here L is nothing but dimension of a component. Alpha is nothing but coefficient of thermal expansion. Tf is freezing temperature and Tr is room temperature. This formula will be useful to calculate the shrinkage allowance. We can see some of the questions. Question number 1. The contraction allowance provided on the pattern and core boxes compensates for the following type of contraction. Option A, liquid contraction. Option B, solidification contraction. Option C, solid contraction. And option D, all of the above. Here, contraction allowance is nothing but shrinkage allowance. Just before we have studied, liquid shrinkage and solidification shrinkage are compensated by riser. Only solid shrinkage is compensated by the allowance providing in the pattern. That is nothing but shrinkage allowance. So, the answer is option C, solid contraction. Question number 2. Shrinkage allowance on pattern is provided to compensate for shrinkage when option A, the temperature of liquid metal drops from pouring to freezing temperature. Option B, the metal changes from liquid to solid state at freezing temperature. Option C, the temperature of solid phase drops from freezing to room temperature. Option D, the temperature of liquid metal drops from pouring to room temperature. Here, shrinkage allowance on pattern will compensate solid shrinkage. And solid shrinkage will happen in solid state and during cooling from freezing temperature to room temperature. So, the answer will be option C, the temperature of solid phase drops from freezing to room temperature. Question number 3. When there is no room temperature change, the total shrinkage allowance on a pattern is independent of option A, pouring temperature of the liquid metal, option B, freezing temperature of the liquid metal, option C, the component size, option D, coefficient of thermal contraction. For solving this question, we have to remember shrinkage allowance formula. That is, change in dimension del L is equal to L into alpha into Tf minus Tr. Now we can easily find the answer. Shrinkage allowance is dependent on the component size. That is nothing but L. Next, shrinkage allowance is dependent on coefficient of thermal contraction. That is nothing but alpha. And shrinkage allowance is dependent on freezing temperature of liquid metal also. That is nothing but Tf. So, the answer will be option A, pouring temperature of the liquid metal. Question number 4. Which one of the following material will require largest size of riser for the same size of casting? Option A, aluminium. Option B, cast iron. Option C, steel. Option D, copper. Actually, the question is, which metal have the larger shrinkage allowance? Here, when compared to aluminium, cast iron, copper, steel only have the more shrinkage allowance. That is 21 mm per meter. So, the answer is option C, steel. Question number 5. Grey cast iron block, 200 into 100 into 10 mm are to be cast in sand mold. Shrinkage allowance for pattern making is 1%. The ratio of the volume of pattern to that of the casting will be option A 0.97, option B 0.99, option C 1.01, option D 1.03. Before attending the question, please read the question very carefully. In question, they have mentioned the metal grey cast iron. Second, shrinkage allowance for pattern making is 1%. Finally, what we have to calculate in this question is ratio of the volume of pattern to the volume of the casting. Now, step 1. Volume of casting we can calculate very easily. Simply, it is length into breadth into depth. 200 into 100 into 10. That we get as 2 into 10 power 5 mm cube. Okay, we can move to the second step. As they have given grey cast iron, it have the negative allowance. That is, for making this particular casting, smaller sized pattern should be used. because final casting will enlarge to about 1% when it is cooled during solid shrinkage. That is the negative allowance. Next, step 3. In step 3, we have to calculate volume of pattern. For volume of pattern, the same formula, length into breadth into depth. But in each length, breadth, depth, 1% of shrinkage allowance has to be deducted, and then we have to calculate the volume of pattern. So after calculating, we get volume of pattern is 1.940598 into 10 power 5 mm cube. Now we can move to step 4. That is very simple. We are going to divide volume of pattern divided by volume of casting. We have calculated the both values. Simply we can divide and finally we got 0.97. So the answer is option A, 0.97. Question number 6. While cooling, a cubical casting of side 40 mm undergoes 3%, 4% and 5% volume shrinkage during the liquid state phase transition and solid state respectively. The volume of metal compensated from the riser is option A 2%, option B 7%, option C 8%, option D 9%. Before attending the question, please read carefully. In question, they have given shrinkage percent happens in different stages. That is, shrinkage during liquid state is 3%, during phase transition is 4%, during solid state is 5%. Now, see the underlined portion in the question. They have asked very clearly that volume of metal compensated from the riser is. We know riser compensates shrinkage during the liquid state and shrinkage during the phase transition. And oversized pattern only compensates the shrinkage during solid state. So, volume compensated by the riser is 3% plus 4%, that is equal to 7%. So, answer is option B, 7%. Question number 7. A cubic casting of 50 mm side undergoes volumetric solidification shrinkage and volumetric solid contraction of 4% and 6% respectively. No riser is used. Assume uniform cooling in all directions. The side of the cube after solidification and contraction is option A 48.32 mm, option B 49.90 mm, option C 49.32 mm, option D 49.96 mm. First, we can identify what are the things given in the question. First, they have given side of the cube before solidification is 50 mm. And next, no riser is used. Third point, shrinkage during solidification is 4%. And next, shrinkage during contraction is 6%. Okay, usually shrinkage during solidification will be compensated by riser. And shrinkage during contraction will be compensated by oversized pattern. But here is no riser. So what will happen is cube initially will undergo solidification shrinkage of 4% and then cube will again undergo contraction shrinkage of 6%. In step 1, we are going to calculate the volume of cube after 4% reduction of solidification shrinkage. Now we are going to multiply volume of cube 50 into 50 into 50 with 0.96, that is after reduction of 4%. So we are getting volume of cube after solidification shrinkage, after calculation we are getting 12,000 mm cube. In step 2, we are again going to repeat the previous step. Now, we have to calculate again volume of cube after solid contraction of 6%. For calculating, we have to multiply the previous obtained volume 12,000 with 0.994. That is after reduction of 6%. Finally, we got the volume as 11,271 mm cube. Okay, in step 3, easily we can calculate the side of cube, that is 3 cube of volume 112771. Finally, we got the answer as 48.32 mm. Next type of pattern allowance is draft allowance. This is to reduce the chances of the damage of mold cavity at the time of pattern removal. Mostly, the vertical faces of the pattern are always tapered. We can see in the diagram. Number 1 is the required product, but we have to give some tapered allowance. In the second diagram, we can see. After casting, we have to machine that portion as a vertical face. Next type of pattern allowance is machining or finish allowance. Mostly, the finish and accuracy achieved in sand casting are generally poor. To get smooth surface finish, machining is needed. So, extra material is to be provided, which is to be subsequently removed by machining or cleaning process. This allowance varies from 2 to 20 mm based on the dimension of casting. Next type of pattern allowance is shake allowance or wrapping allowance. At the time of removal of pattern, the pattern is shaken or wrapped all around. By this, mold cavity get enlarged and supports safe removal of pattern. But because of enlargement, casting size get bigger. To avoid this type of enlarged casting, negative allowance has to be considered during pattern making, and skilled labors also can be used. Last type of pattern allowance is distortion allowance. This is particularly for weaker sections such as long flat portion or V or U-shaped sections. To arrest that distortion, opposite to the direction of distortion, we need to provide some excess amount of material. You can see in the diagram. Number 1 is the required type of casting. But if we make the pattern as like this, we will get the final product like second diagram. To avoid this, in opposite direction, we have to give the excess material. Now we can see one question. Question number 8. Negative allowance is provided on the pattern to take care of. Option A, the distortion allowance. Option B, draft allowance. Option C, the machining allowance. Option D, the shake allowance. Just now we have discussed about the shake allowance, which is nothing but a negative allowance. So the answer is option D, the shake allowance.